Hello and welcome to another episode of Shashank Reviews. We are back after the lockdown and today we have a car that even Leo Messi approves of. Of course you know that. It's the Tiago. Let's go. Hello and welcome to another video, guys. So today we have the Tata Tiago with us and this is the key of the car. This is the facelifted version of the Tata Tiago, which is BS6 compliant, and this design of the Tata, new age design of the Tata, has this tri-arrow design all over its car, be it Nexon, be it the Tigor, be it the Altroz, and it does not use any kind of LED. It has a halogen headlight. This is the side light, but the fancier thing is the fog light has a chrome surround in it. Well, that's a pretty nice touch. The new Tata cars meet the 2020 pedestrian norms and the safety norms, so the bonnet is slightly raised. And coming to the sides, the tire size happens to be 175 60 by 15s, and the alloy wheel design is quite adventurous. It has got a dual tone in it. Opinion, these alloy wheels are one of the nicest in the segment and kind of adventurous as well. The side mirrors have a gloss black finish in it. From the side, even though it's a normal hatchback, not a premium hatchback, the design kind of looks big and it actually kind of suits it. And the A pillar, the B pillar and the C pillar are actually blackened, but this film, I guess Tata Gordagordi, like Birsa Dostosa, and it's empty. It kind of looks incomplete, and well, it started raining anyways. And coming to the back, this tail light is slightly revised. It's kind of similar to the old version. It has a boomerang, but no LED used. And the defogger actually has kind of a new design. Some weird stuff, like not the simple lines. It has some weird designs. This is the high-mounted stop lamp, and these, sorry, the focus is out. I don't know what's up with this. What? So these are the years of the car. It looks like a years, but I don't know what this is. This is the reverse parking camera. And the boot, there is no electromagnetic tailgate opener. You have to put the key and open it. It's a 242 liters of boot. It is quite nice, but the loading lip is really, really high. And that makes it really difficult to put stuff inside the boot. And this is a smaller size tire. And it's, of course, not an alloy wheel. It's a steel wheel. It's a 14-inch tire. The car is running on 15-inch. So, coming inside. So, sorry for the abrupt change in location because apparently rain is not our friend. So, let's go inside of the vehicle. As you can see, being a small car, the width of the car is not so much. So, three people are actually not that comfortable in this car. And as always is my complaint, no adjustable headrest. That's not nice. I mean, come on, considering the price segment, I think that is okay. But I mean, Tata is so known for its safety. Adjustable headrest should have been there. Tata le dina parthe. Well, the leg space is quite nice. Like my knees are not touching. Talking about the under thigh support, it's not that much. And the floor is also not completely flat. It has quite a hump, but that hump is not that significant or that major. But it does miss out on a rare AC vent. In this category, I mean, the AC vent, even Renault Kwid offers a AC vent. That is a miss out. And my head, actually, it's not touching. My head is slightly touching, but I'm 6 feet tall and I'm actually quite comfortable in this car. And you can see the dashboard ahead. It's a dual tone dashboard. It has a gray up top and a beige down. From here, it's a simple dashboard. There's nothing fancy on it. Looks practical. Let's get to the front and see how practical it is. Oh, okay, dear. Look, inside. Let's see down. There is a dead pedal, but it's not actually a dead pedal. It is kind of raised. The floor is raised. And here's some exposed wiring. There's the cubby hole. And the driver's window is a... Oh, sorry. I didn't have a key. Man, can you hear me? Key. Oh. So, there... The window is a one fuck. Windows is a one touch down, but not a one touch up for the driver. Let's get inside. It's raining. Oh my God. So this is the steering wheel of the car. It does have a flat bottom steering, but because of the cover, you can't actually see that. And here's the gear lever. It's a 5-speed gear lever. And in this segment on automatic climate control, a big thumbs up for Tata. Talking about this infotainment system, it is good, but it's not that sleek. It's really hard. It does, as I've already mentioned, it does not have a physical button, so it's really hard to press thing. You have to press it like really sensitively or in a certain way to make it use. I mean, but it's sleek. It has got Android Auto. It's got Apple CarPlay. Would have been really great if we could connect Apple CarPlay and Android Auto wirelessly, but sadly that's not the case. And yeah, it's quite sleek. But this Tata car, it's for every car. Like, it gets a Harman Kardon audio system and it is superb. Yeah, anyways, this is the reverse parking camera. It takes its own sweet time. The noise comes from the camera comes later. I mean, it's really the quality is so. I mean it's not that clear, but does the job, right? This has a Harman Kardon music system. Let's listen to a music. If we don't, that would be not good, right? Easier to break it off, best friends. I don't really understand myself. I don't really understand, need help. I don't wanna be left on the shelf. Couldn't even hear me if I yelled. It's so cold. So see, the music system is really good. I mean, nothing compared in this segment. I mean, it's a segment above. Absolutely dope. This is the another feature of this infotainment system. It has park assist. So that means the feed will be on whenever you're driving ahead, and that will be easier for you to see what's back. That is one handy touch, gotta say. Tata, kudos to that. These are the cup holders. This is the handbrake, conventional handbrake. Here's the storage space. Here you have a storage space that is quite deep, honestly. You can keep phone or mobile phone comfortably. The buttons here are actually pretty weird. I mean, that's the one thing that I don't like about Tata. The button placement is so random. I mean, you can see this is for the front fog light. It's in the middle console. And these are for the locks, center locking. There's no button whatsoever. I mean, lots of hard plastic, as you can see. Of course, as expected. I mean, sorry, you can't see there, but I mean, there's exposed wiring there as well. And this one nifty touch from Tata. You can see this? Yeah, there's a hook. You can put your bag, you can hang your bags so that it does not go itauti. And thing about the glove box, it's a cool, sorry again, the focus is being so bad today. Talking about the glove box, it's a cool glove box, and it's a sweet touch. You press a button here and it's a massive glove box. There's a space here as well. And there is one USB port, one USB point, and that's it. And yeah, 12 volt charging socket as well, but no, not much of connectivity there. Alrighty. Yeah, the horn is kind of placed in an unconventional way. You would think it's here. No, but it's here. I mean, I have pressed it so many times unknowingly, but it might be, it's just my thing. I find it unconventional, but you might find it okay. That's just my point of view. And this is not an auto dimming inside rear view mirror. Of course, this does not have a mirror. I mean, it's also loose. It does not have a mirror. It does have a mirror, and here's you can keep some documents there, but why would you keep it there? It's just gonna block the view. So there's nothing left. That's it. So let's get driving. Don't. Hey, sorry, I forgot to show you the wipers. Actually, it is working. You can see it here. It is working. It is okay. It's on the fastest, and I mean, it's raining. It is being used, and there's the back wiper. Yeah, that's it. Let's get going. So if you ask me what Tata Tiago is, I'd say it is a small car. It is one easy car to drive, and because it has a powerful engine, a 1.2 liter naturally aspirated engine that produces around 86 horsepower and 130 newton meters of torque, it is a light car as well. And the power to weight ratio actually matches this car. It suits the car. I mean, it does not feel laggy or anything.
of course, it's not an enthusiastically good car. I mean, it is safe. Talking about safe, it scores a 4-star NCAP rating and global NCAP rating, which makes it one of the safest cars in this segment. What is this segment? This segment consists of Suzuki, Datsun, Hyundai, specifically Sandero, WagonR, and maybe Datsun Redigo as well. And this is, as I say, it's an easy car because see, the steering is so light, you can actually twirl it with one hand. It's that easy. It is that simple. And because of its compact nature, you don't feel you're driving a big car. You know, it's really small. You can see every sides. You can see the bonnet. You can see the sides. You can just feel so cozy. You can feel so comfy in this car, which is a great thing, as the targeted audience for this car will be a first time buyer. So talking about the ride quality of this car, it is good. I should say it's good because, I mean, it is comfortable, but it has that hint of stiffness on it that makes it kind of, as the car enthusiasts, as the car reviewers say, a European style. It's not that stiff, it's not that comfy that makes you bouncy on the roads. I mean, on paper, even though on paper it has like one of the best power figures in this category, but when you drive this on the road, I mean, it's so. The low-end lag, even though it's a naturally aspirated engine, the engine pull is not too great. I mean, it's light, it's everything. But see, if I put this in a fourth gear and if I really slow it down, and we are at around 37 kilometers, the pull, it just does not want to pull. So this is like, when it gets into higher RPM, like around 3000 to 4000 RPM, then it starts to pull. Because it is a three cylinder engine, after that point it's smooth. It's definitely smooth. Not saying that refinement level are really nice, but when it goes on the high revs, the three cylinderness of this engine can be really felt, and that's not good. Yes, there is body noise, there is tire noises coming in, there are wind noises coming inside the cabin, but that three cylinderness just takes the sweetness of this refined engine. It is undoubtedly refined engine, but that three-cylinderness sometimes makes it bothersome. Well, as I've already told you earlier, it is not an enthusiastic car. Yes, it does not have a body roll, but the steering feedback, it's nothing. There's nothing. This car is actually perfect for family who are looking for a practical, safe, easygoing car, who does not like driving enthusiastically, who are just normal drivers who love feature-rich car, safe car. This car is perfect for them, and for the first-time buyers as well, as I've already said. And this car actually is available in 8 variants, not in Nepal. Sadly, it is available in 6 variants in Nepal. And this car starts from 24,99,000 and goes up to 31,99,000.
Right,
man, fuck. Oh, yeah, our left is on board. Police, sir.
Yeah,
right now. Yeah, red light ball. I think. They bought it. So this car starts from 24,99,000 and goes up to 31,99,000. Well, in this price bracket, if you're looking for cars, this is one of the better options you can find. Reason being, if you want to compare this with the competition, this is, in my opinion, built together really nicely. The build quality is actually pretty nice. It's put together well. But the drawback of this car is just the engine. The three-cylinder engine is not so good. Compared to the competition, the engine on the Suzuki and Hyundai are far ahead in this category, in this petrol engine. And Tata needs to up their game in the petrol engine department, be it for Nexon, be it for Altroz, be it for Tiago. The petrol engine from Tata is not good. Sorry to break this to you, but this is what it is. I see a water, I do this. Haha. Anyways, where was I? And so the petrol engine of the Tata cars are actually not that great, to be honest. So yeah, that's my vlog on the Tata Tiago. If you like this kind of content, do hit the subscribe button. We've just touched 200 subscribers. Yay, let's grow. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Can we, let's keep a like target, shall we? 70 likes. let's see if we can make it. That would be really great. If you like this, please share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel. You can find me on Instagram as well at Shashank Reviews. You can find me on Twitter at Twitter as well. I'll put the channel, the handles somewhere in the screen or in the description box. Until then, yeah, and also, yeah, I would have done an outro, but a conventional outro. Yeah, I would have done a conventional outro for sure, but because of the rain, sorry for this abrupt ending, I should say. But thank you for watching. I'll see you pretty soon. And thank you for being so patient. We're back and we're trying to be... Oh my God, just look at this. This is a pond. What the hell? Let's see. No, I wanna make it... Yeah, but this man's... I should know. Woo! I love this. Anyone who drives a car, I don't think people love this. So yeah, see you soon and thank you for watching. Bye bye.
This kind looks incomplete. Man, pani pour di raha hai.
Gaadi hai.
Seat backs, but the under thigh. So there is no keyless entry, as you can know, as you can, as I've... So let's get inside. So there is no keyless entry, so that's why, I mean, no, nothing at.
Horsepower and 113 newton meters of torque.
Twark.
Twark. Twark.